Many people know that one of the areas of specialty that I work with people in my practice are people who are who have been through emotional neglect. And it could be emotional neglect that, you know, you've experienced when you were a child, either having misattuned or unattuned, or just you know, parents or caregivers who really didn't understand you, not by any flaw of their own, but really their own limitation of emotionally being able to connect. Or because, you know, they you know, were immigrants, or maybe because they had their own stressors or their own traumas, their own relationship issues, or some health concerns in the family or with their friends that really came up. Or people who were in adult relationships where their partner or their lover or whoever it was really emotionally neglectful. And emotionally neglectful relationships are relationships where there's some experience of abandonment, where you have a certain emotional need that's either never acknowledged or addressed, or it's addressed but it's ignored or, you know, brushed away. And the other day, a friend of mine sent me a song, and it's actually in French, and it's called, it's titled Papa Ute, and it's composed by someone who's talking about a little boy who is singing and talking about this dream, this fantasy, and this really this sadness of not having a dad. You know, his dad, the songwriter talks about, you know, his storyline and his narrative of not of having an absentee dad. Dad was alive but never really physically around or emotionally around. And, you know, watching the song really touched my heart, because I think it personifies like the, and I'll put a link beneath this video, and in the blog that I write about this, and my thoughts and my feelings and my hopes and wishes for any or all of you that have ever felt, you know, a little bit of coldness or a little bit of feeling misunderstood in your younger years or even recently. The sadness is just because you see this little child who's looking for connection, and he literally has this like porcelain figure, which is his dad, and he's motionless, and, you know, he doesn't have any expression. This version of dad, and he takes him with him like he's trying to play ball, he's trying to read the newspaper, watch TV, and there is just no responsiveness. And, you know, some of us may have been in relationships, either short-term relationships, long-term relationships. There might be someone in the family, there might be someone in your community or in your friend group that kind of interacts with you in that way, where you almost start wondering, like, are you nuts, or is anyone emotionally home? And it can leave an impact. And, you know, I think this song is so significant because for so many people that I work with, and who have done incredible work or are looking to do healing work, one of the pieces of work is actually validating and acknowledging the absence of that person or the lack of responsiveness, and that it's healthy and normal to need some kind of emotional reaction or an emotional interaction. And it's not always something so big. People sometimes think, oh, your emotional needs are so big. Like, no, many times you had a very normal, healthy need, and if it goes ignored, you start thinking that you're too much, or you're never gonna have that need responded to. So, you know, this is, I think this video is for anyone who's looking to develop any kind of a deeper level of empathy. If you're looking to connect with your own children more, if this could even just be a wake-up call of really deepening your ability to be more present, because sometimes children in today's generation feel like mommy or daddy or whoever is not present, because we're distracted with our phones or other things going on. Or if any of you have ever had someone who you felt like really wasn't there, either they were ill, they had a limitation, the relationship was just not a healthy one where the emotional needs weren't met for you or for someone in your life, I think this could be a powerful, you know, video to watch to kind of really bring up those emotions and kind of let them, you know, surface and let go of some of them. In the work, in therapy work at our practice, where I work and some of the clinicians that work at our practice, we work with people who've been through trauma and neglect or abandonment wounds, and we work specifically with this. And sometimes we'll use psychodrama, which means we might help the person play out a scene or a certain need or a certain conversation which was never had, either with a therapist or with some other kind of prop to really work with the trauma or with the neglect that took place but was never really given a space, so they can let go of that, so they don't unconsciously keep getting into relationships where other people neglect them, or, you know, let go of that so they could show up for themselves, or, you know, just be able to feel lighter in their body and their mind, just feel more whole and okay, and really embrace possibilities of love and life. Yeah, and we have a lot of different creative methods, obviously, different therapy methods. We use EMDR, we use a lot of the mind-body methods like somatic therapy, art therapy, talk therapy, creating a narrative of the unspoken, giving it space to be spoken. But just to read you some of the lyrics, you know, this boy, it starts off by him saying like, tell me where he comes from at last, I'll know where to go. Mommy says that you look hard, you always find something. She says he's never far away. He leaves very often for work, right? And then the chorus is, where's my dad? Tell me, where are you, my dad? Right, because the title of the song means, where are you, father? And it's this child who's seeking. And I think that, you know, with everything I'm talking about, I think like some of the ways to feel really wholesome, some of the ways to really feel complete and connected is when we're seeking and our seeking is responded to. So it could be an internal seeking. It could be responding more to those in our life. It could be responding to a seeking that we have. You might have a certain need, an emotional need, a spiritual need, a mental need, intellectual need, or a sexual need that really needs to be noticed or acknowledged. So I think this is just the jumpstart for our conversation about acknowledging the unspoken, but specifically for neglect and abandonment wounds where things are not spoken about openly. I think this is a great song. So if this feels right for you, I invite you to read the lyrics and listen to the song. And if it lands on any sensitive spot, my heart is sending a whole lot of care to yours.